everyone. Well, I guess by this time I don't need to introduce myself, do I? I suppose all of you know what my name is, but just in case, I'm gonna remind you that my name is Estrella. Yep, you heard it right. Not Australia, not Australia, and not Soraya either. But whatever, I'm almost gone, so don't even bother. Well, if you remember, I came here to volunteer with BRYR September 2010. So if you think about it, it's a year over. Can you believe that? How time flies. But well, before leaving, I'm gonna show you all my EVS Adventure. Do you like reading? Well, I always prefer movies. So take your Coke, popcorn, and let's start! As EVS stands for European Volunteer Service, I was able to choose any European country to volunteer in, and I decided to come to Ireland. Reasons? Well, English was the main one, to be honest. And where in Ireland? Dublin City. But the truth is that there's a story how I got here. Do you want to find out? Keep watching then.
Oh honey, did you see this? There's a program here we can apply for.
Oh really? What's that about?
Well, actually it's not only one thing.
Meaning?
Meaning we can choose from a bunch of options. Let me read it for you.
Yeah, better, because I don't get it.
Well, here it says. The European Volunteer Service, or EVS, is a branch of the European Commission's Youth in Action program that offers young Europeans aged between 18 and 30 the chance to make a real difference to the world and to their own prospects by volunteering abroad. So honey, we could go, live there for a year, improve our English, and I'm sure we're gonna learn a lot and have an amazing experience. So what do you think?
Well, why not? Let's do it!
Okay, then the next thing to do is look for organizations and apply. Here in the side we have organizations and projects. Let's see. Oh, look at this one!
Well, what is it?
You're gonna love this one. It says it has a communication in IT area.
Oh, really? Sounds great.
Well, I find it really hard to decide, so I'm gonna apply for several of them.
Oh, that's a very good idea, so send your CV and motivation letter then.
Yeah, I know.
I'm done.
Me too.
Fingers crossed. As you can see, I got it. And so does he. My volunteering place was Ballymun, in the north of Dublin City. If we look at Ballymun today, it is hard to imagine that in 1950s it was a small village of a few cottages at the junction of Century Avenue and Ballymun Road. All around it was farmland with just a few large houses in between. In 1960s, many people lived in the city center in all random buildings called tenements. Before this, tenements were the big houses of the rich. But when the healthy owners moved into the more fashionable areas, the houses were divided into small units and poor people moved in. Often, two families shared one room, or families lived in the landing. There were also no bathrooms and not enough toilets for all the people. By 1963, many of the tenements had become too dangerous to live in, but their tenants could not afford to buy their own house. So the government decided to build new blocks of flats for them in Ballymun. And what is the best way to house many people very quickly? High towers with as many flats as possible. And so thought the architects. So what happened? That between 1966 and 1969, Ballymun Towers were built on the outskirts of the city. There were seven of them. Each was 15 stories tall, with six flats to each floor. Equals 90 flats per tower. Only a view, eh? Apart from the towers, the government also built some smaller blocks of flats and some houses in the area. The towers were named after the seven leaders of the East Rising of 1916. That were Thomas Clark, Sean McDermott, Thomas McDonough, Patrick Pearse, Eamon Cant, James Connolly, and Joseph Blanket. When the first families moved into their new flats in 1966, they were delighted. They had a couple of bedrooms, running hot water, central heating, flush toilets and lifts, luxuries they had never had before. All went well at first, but soon they discovered that they had nowhere to shop. The lifts kept breaking down, the heating could not be lowered, and they promised public swimming pool, meeting places and play areas were never built because the government had run out of money. Ballymun seemed to be miles away from the city center. People were unhappy, so those who could afford to move did. During the 1980s, things got worse. Many people had no jobs, and there were problems with stolen cars and drugs. Many of the flats stood empty, because nobody wanted to live in Ballymun anymore. Eventually, it was decided that Ballymun needed a complete renewal. But this time, Dublin City Council, who ran the place, wanted to do the planning together with the people living in Ballymun. There were many meetings and discussions, and a new plan was drawn up. The towers had to be knocked down, and new houses and much smaller apartment blocks had to be built, as well as all the facilities which had been planned but never happened in 1960s. In 2004, Pierce Tower was the first of the seven towers to be pulled down. Lots of families have moved into their new homes which they had helped to design, and now, for the first time, have a front and back garden where the children can play. In the middle of all these changes Ballymun has suffered, that was one that totally made a difference. I'm talking about a symbol for young people around Ballymun and beyond. We know it under the name of the Reco.
Hey Lily.
Hey Rose, what are you up to?
Not much, what about you?
Going to the club.
Rego?
No, jail.
Well, why would you do... sarcasm.
Of course I'm not. Rego is like the funnest place ever.
Oh, really? Tell me about it.
No, it's not. I'm just saying that. Of course I'm not.
I just told... I asked you to tell me about it.
Well, there's a summer buzz going on during July, which I am signed up for. Mm-hmm. There's all different trips. There's a sports one, and that has like football, Gaelic, hurling, and camogie.
Do you have swimming? I'm very good at swimming.
Horse riding and swimming.
Oh, okay.
Sports thing is a brilliant thing, and then that's really gone. And one trip, the first week trip is like Clarelard, and there's like the next week is Clatterhead, then College Farm, then Clatterhead again. It's very good. And then there's like art. Would you do art projects then and all?
I really like art.
We did a stairs for the summer, and it was really cool. My stair was a paramour and a desk with a shoe, a pencil, a paper, and a hand up on it.
Well, obviously you'd have to put your hand up to ask a question, or you could just shout it out.
Yeah, and there's music on in it, which like
I like music.
Yes, I'm in a band. It's called Funky Metal. It's very good.
Oh, cool.
And I played the guitar, and we did our third gig. We did one the axis, or two on the axis, yeah, the axis, and one in the record. And it's very good. And like, there's different things. Tanya is the girl who runs it, and then like Darren, Gavin, and Willa, who helps out with it, and it's very good. And also Colin, the old person.
The old person?
I don't know his age, so I'll just call him Colin. And
well, everybody over 25 is old.
Over 14 is old.
Yeah, I guess so. I'm not near that yet. Another year to go.
And in Digi, the club I'm going to stay. Digital storytelling.
Oh, okay. So you call it Digi.
Yeah, it's short and easy. We mix crafts with multimedia, and like we make projects, and sometimes we do. Our last project was on stereotypes and how different each one is, and we recorded our voices and then uploaded it onto the Apple Mac, which is in CHQ, and we made like a plaster scene set of College Green, was it? I think it was College Green. And we made like characters like emos and spicers, and then we're going to let the team run and play what we think about what's good and what's bad, and it's very good. And then there's like different projects on, So there'd be drama, that's a project that you're doing and playing right now. The girl whose best friend is most people. And
what's that about?
It's about a girl. The first one was about a girl. I won't tell you, but it's okay, it's different on you. There's a girl, and her grandmother dies, and she runs away. She runs away, and then her friends are looking for her, but while her friends are looking for her, one of the two characters in it get together, and in the end, get married and have the wedding. It's very cool, but you get to slow down. It's very funny. And there's City as well, that's computers, and you get to go on the internet, and like you get to go, say, at 4 o'clock for an hour, 5 o'clock for an hour, 6 o'clock for an hour. It's very good. And on Saturdays, you only have to pay your, on the weekdays, it's very good. It's very good.
Sounds fun. No, it actually sounds awesome. No, I actually can't think of
it. It's epic. It's just epic.
Yeah, I guess.
You're never bored.
Really?
So much activity. You sure come.
I'm gonna pick up a form.
Right, see ya.
See ya.
Bye.
Well, what can I say? As I'm a computer geek, it couldn't have turned out any other way. I just find that most of my time was on EVS surrounded by computers. I had loads of different and amazing groups, such as Chiclets, Samba, and Young Mothers. But Digital and City filled up the most of my time.
Me not working hard. Yeah, right, picture that with a Kodak. Or better yet, go to Times Square.
Hi, Bernie! Hello! I brought you a cup of coffee.
Oh, thank you, that's so good.
Naya, Neo, that's right. I'm gonna love you
tonight. Give me a...
And that's all, folks.